Good morning, good morning, good morning. Grace and peace. We're going to begin in just a few minutes. As you are logging in, good morning, family. Good morning, Jan. Good morning, Facebook. We are going to begin in just a few short moments. This is the day that the Lord has made. The Bible says we should all rejoice and be glad. Good morning, grace and peace. Start in just a few short moments. You're logging in and on on platforms. I'd like you to go ahead and log in, share, like and or share, excuse me. Just kind of get it started. Benji Music, good morning. Grace and peace to you all. This is the day that the Lord hath made. The Bible says we should all rejoice and be glad in it. We're going to start in just a few short moments. Please, again, like and or share. If you have not had the opportunity to download the Movement Church app, please do so. Google Play, Movement Nation. Apple Store, Movement Nation. If you stand in the need of prayer, please submit your prayer request to prayer@movementchurch.tv. That's right, prayer, P-R-A-Y-E-R, at movementchurch.tv.
That's right, prayer.
Grace and peace to you all. Facebook, please like and share. If you haven't had an opportunity, if they walk over to YouTube and subscribe to our channel, go ahead and do so. Today we're talking about simplicity as we have all focused over the last few weeks, which is our encouragement to fix your eyes on Jesus. Today we want to begin discussing simplicity and the simple life. Again, today is June the 30th, 2020. So much going on in our world, so much going on in our nation. Not sure if you are keeping up, friends and family, with what's going on in the world, but there is a lot going on in the world. There is the Saharan dust desert, a storm that is heading our way. There are, of course, rising numbers with COVID-19. They say by October, 180,000 individuals could actually pass and or die, die of COVID-19. And so we are wondering what you all are not just thinking. We realize what you are thinking. A lot of us are fixing our eyes on the things of the world. We're fixing our eyes on society and cultural shifts and changes. We're looking at the news. We're seeing what's going on with racism and racial reconciliation. This is a topic. But then there are new news that's saying, hey, we haven't even seen the worst yet. Like, the worst is yet to actually come. And so there's so much going on in our world that we've been encouraging everyone who's been tuning in with us on Tuesdays and Thursdays to fix their eyes on Jesus, Hebrews chapter 12. Verses 1 through 3, really. But specifically in that text, over the last week, we've been discussing that portion or that part of the text that says, laying aside every encumbrance. And because there are so many encumbrances in our lives, that's people, that's places, that's things, that's hindering us from running the race, we've really begun to ask the question, what in our lives has overcomplicated our lives? What do we need to simplify? What do we need to lay aside? What is our weight? And so we began the conversation this week in talking about simplification or simplifying and what it means for us to simplify moving from busy to purposeful. Mm-hmm. Like, and so many of us are really, really busy. We're busy keeping up with the Joneses. We're busy trying to keep up with what's going on in the world. We're busy, 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 running, 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 running. And as we are running, we are many times losing purpose. And I think the church, and not just the church, but other sectors of society has also lost focus because we've lost what we have fixed our attention to.
Absolutely.
Like sometimes we forget what the mission and the vision is.
Right.
And when you forget what the mission and the vision is, when you forget keeping the main thing, you ultimately begin to accumulate and pile on layers of either programs or layers of possession, whether it be clothes, whether it be cars, whether it be purses, whether it be whatever your fix is. There's just so much that we all acquire that hinders us from actually running the race that Christ has set before us. So what are your thoughts? Are there some things that you can right now even think about that you may need to get rid of? What are your thoughts, family and friends? Because we've been able to identify some things. And as a church, we are asking all of our partners, even right now, to not just as adults, but as a family, begin to think about what you can
purge.
Deliberately, deliberately detach yourselves from.
Yeah.
What is it? What is it that you should deliberately detach yourselves from? I've seen some friends even post over the last few days, like, I'm deliberately detaching from social media for the next 30 days.
Wow.
Because it's affecting me. It's impacting me. It's causing me to become frustrated, bitter, angry, broken.
Yes.
And so we really have to think about, man, what are we focused on? What do we need to deliberately detach from? This week, I want you all to maybe begin writing a list of possessions that cause anxiety.
Or, as you just stated, social media isn't necessarily a possession, right? It's
right.
an activity or an action.
Right.
So that list needs to include the activity, the action, the possession that you need to begin carving away or purging, deliberately detaching from for the sake of simplicity.
Yes.
Yeah. So what are some of those things? What are some of those things that you can outright, somebody can think right now of something they need to let go of?
Yeah, absolutely. Good morning. Good morning, grace and peace to you all. Good morning, Natasha. Good morning, Benji Music. Again, grace and peace to you all. We're just simply talking about simplifying our lives as we look and as we take personal assessments, as we, you know, fix our eyes on Jesus and try and not be asphyxiated on, like, the things of the world.
Right.
Things that's transpiring in our culture. And I know it causes worry, it causes anxiety, but the scripture says, "In whom of you by worrying can add a single hour to your life?" And so many of us are trying to figure out how we're going to eat next month,
right,
how we're going to survive this pandemic,
right,
that we lose focus and we take our eyes off of Jesus and we begin trying to figure out what it is that we can do. And so that also adds layers of busyness into our lives, and it doesn't help us actually simplify our lives. So what we just want you to do this week is, if you're not going to talk back to us this morning, which is fine, which we want you to do this week is just begin creating a list.
Yeah.
Create a list, things that cause anxiety. Things that cause anxiety. If you're not sure, think through the things you have and ask yourself, what if I get rid of blank? If you're not quite sure, what if I get rid of this shirt? What if I get rid of this jacket? What if I get rid of this video game? What if I get rid of this book? Because I've been purging, to use your term, the bookshelf.
Yes.
As you can see, books are starting to lean because I've been purging the bookshelf, because there are some books that I just don't need anymore.
They're just there.
They're there for me to feel good about my book collection.
Wow.
And that's prideful.
Wow.
That's prideful.
That's
look at my book collection. And so it's just the accumulation of things and things and things.
Right.
Now, there's some books that are priceless that can't be replaced.
Mm-hmm.
Things that my dad wrote in.
Mm-hmm.
Things that your father wrote in in their pastorates. Those things are priceless.
Right.
And so you have to ask yourself, what if I get rid? If I get rid of a book that my father wrote in, then that means I can't pass on a generational blessing to our children, so they won't be able to see the things that their father studied in and then the things that their grandfather studied in. And so we miss passing on a generational blessing.
That's good.
But there are some books back there that I just acquired through Bible college, through seminary, that are just there, are books that I just went to a rummage sale, and because I wanted my book collection to be full, I bought things that I necessarily didn't actually need. And so, again, family, think about what you need to get rid of.
Yeah, so what I'm hearing you say is you're asking yourself and you're encouraging us to ask ourselves, what in your life do you have that brings substantive value to yourself and to others?
Yeah.
Not just what can I just hold on to because it reminds me that I succeeded in something or that I did well in something or that I look good in this or that I look good in that. What value does it bring to me and to others?
Yeah.
And then could we add for the glory of God?
For the glory of God, because there are things that we possess that God never gets glory from. And the text says in Matthew 22:37-30, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. That term strength there literally means to love him with all of your possessions.
That's right.
Watch this. Your cell phone is strength when it's used to the glory of God.
That's good.
It's a weakness when it's used to the glory of your flesh.
That's right.
It's strength when it's used to the glory of God. However, it is a weakness when it's used to the glory of your flesh. So we must purge because there are things in our lives that we hold on to that never gives God glory.
Yeah, they're not tools, they're encumbrances.
They're encumbrances. And this is why the writer of Hebrews says, therefore, since there's so great a cloud of witnesses surrounding us, let us lay aside, set aside, deliberately detach from every distraction that's hindering you. And the text furthermore says, and sin, but we're not even dealing with sin right now, all right? That's an internal. We're talking about externals here right now. We're talking about externals. That is the encumbrances, not sin that we're having to deal with internally, but we're talking about the external encumbrances. And so what is an encumbrance in your life? Who is an encumbrance in your life? What ideology is an encumbrance in your life? Watch this, because the writer of Hebrews in that text, in 12, he's literally, the encumbrance was what was ritualistic. The encumbrance was being bound to the law. The encumbrance was not the freeing grace of the gospel. That's why the text furthermore says, for the joy set before him, he endured the cross. They're saying, man, why are y'all still holding on to legalistic oppression and bondage? Christ has set you free. To whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Why go back? That's why he's saying, therefore, lay aside all of that stuff and run freely the race that Christ has set before you. But we can't run when we're holding on to things. And brothers and sisters, friends and family, we just want to encourage you to think about what is it that you need to simplify. We're talking about simplifying our lives. Why? For the glory of God. Why? So we can run.
Drop the weight.
Man, we got to drop weight. Somebody, come, y'all talk back to us. We got to drop weight.
Drop weight.
We got to drop weight.
Shit, drop it.
Yeah, yeah.
Drop it. And that could that be even the physical weight?
Uh-huh.
Right?
Watch this. Oh, that was good because it can't be physical weight. Some of us need to lose weight.
Exactly, because it's keeping us from running race. Come on now.
Watch this. You're running, but you're not. Watch this because the text, man, and I don't even have my but this is literally a marathon. We're not talking about a sprint.
That's right.
And so
that's
some of you, you're running, but you're only running a 100-yard dash.
Yeah.
You're not running the marathon. So you're not running the race that is set before you. You're running the race that you want to run, and it's because you're physically.
Come on, come on. And you're not running for endurance. Yeah. You're running for completion.
Yeah. Yeah, you have to endure this thing. So
on,
again, family and
y'all
friends,
responding.
Good morning, grace and peace to you all on both platforms, Instagram as well as Facebook. If you are just joining in with the conversations, we are talking about simplifying our lives. Life has been really, really rough this year.
Yes,
2020 has been, let me say it how I feel it, hell for many of us. For some, it's been a blessing. For some, it's been a blessing. But for a lot of people, for a lot of our constituents, for a lot of our viewers, for a lot of our Facebook family, for a lot of those who are in our relational network, it's been hell.
And we're still in it.
And we're still in it.
We're still in it. 2020 is not over.
And so we're talking about what is it that you need to deliberately detach from in your life. This week, our homework, literally, as a church network, a network of simple churches that are embedded not just in the marketplace, but in the home, we're actually asking everyone to really think about, what is it in my life? What possessions do I have? Do I have, Instagram family, what possessions do I have? Is it furnishings? Is it shoes? Is it clothes? Is it handbags?
Yeah.
Is it DVDs? Watch this. Why do we still have a big old box of CDs and DVDs?
Because one day we think CDs are going to be like records.
Yeah, I mean, but
we think they're going to have some sort of value later,
but what value?
A record has a value now. I'm just saying. That's what somebody's saying. Somebody's saying my DVD player is at some point going to become vintage.
Yeah. Right.
It's going to possibly even be an, like, for example, my mother has a record player, an 8-track player sitting at home. It's vintage and a family heirloom.
And it's in the way.
And it's
and it's in the way and it's never used.
Yeah.
We've been, until I
come turn it on.
Man, it's been turned on. But that I know once in the last 14 years.
No.
In the last 14 years. It's never used. So again, family, again, this week we want you to begin to list the possessions with which you feel most anxiety about, which possessions you feel most anxiously attached to. If you're not sure, think through the things and ask yourself this question. If I get rid of blank, how will I feel? If I get rid of this car, if I get rid of this jacket, if I get rid of this Blu-ray, if I get rid of this video game, children, young men, if I get rid of these toys, if I get rid of this appliance, if I get rid of this kitchenware, like why?
Are you talking to me?
No, I'm not talking to you. I'm just talking. Y'all talk back to us. So ask yourselves those questions. If I get rid of this, how would I feel? Now, watch this.
The truth of the matter is you've already picked your favorite.
Yeah, you've already
picked it. Because you're using it most consistently.
Yeah.
So you've picked the thing that you wear the most. You've picked the thing that you use the most. Mm-hmm. And you're using it consistently.
Amen.
So everything that you're not using, like you said earlier this morning, anything that you haven't used in 30 days, and for some of us, or for some things, some categorical things, a year, then put those things aside. Shed them. Drop them.
Purge them.
Carve them. Purge them.
Yeah.
For the sake of simplicity. Yeah. I stole your train of thought. I see it.
No, you didn't steal my train of thought.
I'm sorry. I was just sitting there
thinking about some things that I want to get rid of.
Yeah.
I'm sitting here thinking and I'm imagining, okay, what does it look like for me to get rid of that? Like, this is the season. I believe this is a season. And remember, seasons are not 3 months. Seasons are where God has us. And right now, I believe that God has the church, the body of Christ, in a purging season. Good morning, family. I think he has us in a purging season because there are programs that the church has been doing that have not been to his glory. Mm-hmm. So he's trying to give us an opportunity to ask ourselves the question, what is it that the ministry is doing? Let's talk corporately and collectively. What is it that the ministry is doing that the pastor now has to think about? We don't really need to do that anymore because we were doing it and we were only doing it because we've always done it. You understand what I'm saying? We got to ask ourselves.
But not necessarily that is because it's been bringing value to the body.
Right.
Not necessarily because it's been glorifying God. We've been doing it because it's been a part of our religious activity.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
But does it...
Encumbrance.
Come on.
Encumbrance. So again, family, we're having to do that as leaders. We're asking ourselves the question, do we still need to do this? Is this to God's glory? Does this help us with the vision?
Right.
And the mission, not of Dre, but the vision and the mission of Jesus.
That's good.
Because
that's good.
His vision, God, the Father's vision, was that all tongues, all nations, Revelation 7 and 9, bow down and worship him. His desire is that no one be lost.
Yeah.
No one be left behind. Yeah. His plan is for his believers, those that have been saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Spirit, to actually participate in his plan, which is to make disciples of all the nations.
And though the plan doesn't change, how we actively participate may need some adjustments.
It may need some adjustments.
More
Amen.
Especially as the world goes round.
Yes, we got a comment. God is really getting us to focus on what's truly important.
Yeah.
Absolutely. He has stripped everything from us. Good stuff, y'all. Absolutely. I believe, Natasha, that he's not only getting us to focus on what's truly important.
That's right.
But I think he's also getting us to think about who is really important.
That's good.
So it's for us in our rhythms, it's move up, connect to Christ. That's really important. I think it's really important for the body of Christ to connect to Christ, spend some time with him through slowing, silence, solitude.
And now simplicity.
And now through simplicity. I think it's important for us to connect not only to Christ, but to the culture, because Christ, through his incarnation, he connected to us. Mm-hmm. All right? He dwelt amongst us. And so I think we have to become like him by doing that very thing. And in order to do that, sometimes we have to, what we're talking about today, deliberately detach from distractions.
Yes.
And some people are distractions. Yes. So we have to focus on what truly is important. Thank you, Natasha. We got to focus on what's truly important, mm-hmm. and who's truly important. Mm-hmm. Deliberately detach from distractions. People, places, things, ideas. Why? So we can run the race.
Run the race.
That God has set before us. Good stuff. The whole America system is being revamped. Quite amazing. Good morning, Charity. Thank you so much for that. Amen.
Yes.
I was about to say Pastor Sam Ball. That almost is fella. Amen, Pastor Sam Ball. Amen. Because I just love the way he says pastor. Amen. Brother Sam Ball, yes. We appreciate it. So again, thank you, family and friends. You tuned in. We thank you for your comments. We are praying that you are wrestling with what we are requesting of you today. We're asking you this week to identify some things in your life. Join us on this coming Thursday. We're going to revisit these conversations. Yeah. We're praying that you would by that time have identified some things that you need to let go of, or some people that you need to let go of, or some ideologies that you need to let go of, or some things that you need to let go of. I'm thinking about some things right now. I'm probably getting ready to have, I think our neighborhood is having a yard sale in a couple of weeks. We're going to make us some money, honey, because I'm getting ready to clear house.
Clean it.
We're going to clear house.
Let's go.
Carly, you got some toys you need to throw away?
Sure. Say good morning, Carly.
All right, well, we got some toys we need to throw away. We're going to purge the house. We're going to purge toys. We're going to clean up the house. So, again, thank you, guys. Let us pray with you really quickly. Father, thank you today for your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. Father, we thank you for this time that we have shared together, just having some candid conversations. Thank you for this pastor chat. We thank you for our relational network, those who have tuned in and on this morning on both social platforms, Instagram as well as Facebook. Thank you for those who have tuned in. Again, God, we ask now that you would begin revealing to us the very things in our lives that are hindering us from running the race that your Son, Christ Jesus, has set before us. God, we ask right now that you would give us the strength to deliberately detach from those things, whether they be people, whether they be ideas, whether they be possessions that we have. God, give us the strength to let go of those things. Mm-hmm. Because many of those things are creating anxiety in our lives, in our hearts, and causing us to live duplicitous as believers. And so, God, we know that you have not called us to duplicity. You've called us, Father, to simplicity. And so, Father, because we have been called to simplicity, because we have been called first and foremost to glorify you with all that we have, God, we would just pray now that our minds be renewed, that our minds not focus on the things of the world, but that they will focus on the things of the kingdom. God, we thank you again. We thank you again for your Son's redemptive work on the cross.
Thank you.
We thank you, God, for what he has done. He has restored and reconciled us, and he has now given us, according to your word in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 17 through 21, God, he has given us not only a message of reconciliation, which is the gospel, but he has also given us a ministry of reconciliation. And so, God, we embrace our ministries today, individually, but also collectively. We embrace the ministry of reconciliation. Because we have been vertically reconciled, God, now we attempt and we use all of our efforts to horizontally reconcile with those who do not look like us, with those who do not have the same hue as us, God. We vertically reconcile. In your Son's name we pray, but we also participate. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Awesome. Thank you guys again for tuning in and tuning in. We love you.
We love you.
Dre moves.
Sean moves.
Carly moves.
The question that we ask is, are you moving? Go
are
in peace.
You moving?
Have a blessed and prosperous remainder of your day. We'll holler.